Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I'm going to talk about the 2021 Child Tax Payment Advance. As some of you may already know, there has been an update to the 2021 Child Tax Credit. And for those who qualify, you may have already received your first payment on July 15th, and you will continue to receive payments throughout the end of 2021. And so related to these Child Tax Credits and the update to the amount received for the Child Tax Credit, for 2021, I wanted to talk about the top 10 things you should know about the changes with this child tax credit / stimulus check. And so number 10, which may be number one for some people, is the eligibility and phase out. And so as far as whether you're eligible or not for this child tax credit advance payment, it will be based on your 2019 and your 2020 taxes. And if you received any of these stimulus checks in the past going back to 2020, the eligibility is basically the same. And so if you're a single person and you make under $75,000 and you have children, you are eligible for the full child tax credit for 2021. If you are head of household and you make under $112,500, you are eligible. And if you file as married filing jointly, then the eligibility amount is at $150,000 per year. Now, whether you're single or head of household, the amount that makes you ineligible is $200,000 per year. And for married filing jointly, that is doubled to $400,000. And so thinking about the two sets of numbers that I just provided, if you are in between the two numbers that I stated, that means you have some range as far as how much you'll get for the child tax credit, as far as you getting either the full amount or as far as you not getting anything if you're in that middle range. Now you're probably wondering how much it is if you haven't seen that payment or if you haven't received it yet. And that goes to the ninth thing that you need to know is that the child tax credit actually increased. And so last year, the child tax credit was $2,000 per child. With this update for the stimulus check, it also increased the overall child tax credit that you receive in 2021. That has been increased from $2,000 up to $3,600. So if not for this increase, the actual child tax credit that you would receive per child, it would also be one-third less had they not increased this amount. Now, as far as how much you will receive per child, it actually varies. And that takes us to number eight. And that's that all children are not created equal, at least as far as this child tax advance payment. And so if you have children that are five and under, the amount that you will receive for those children are $300 each. And if you have a child age 6 to 17, for each child in this age range, you will receive $250 each per month. Now, as I mentioned, that goes up to age 17. So that actually takes us to the seventh thing you need to know, which is that if you're 18 or older, there's still a chance that you could get something. And so for 18-year-olds who still live at home and don't file their own taxes as an independent, then the parents of that 18-year-old will be eligible to receive a one-time $500 payment for their 18-year-old. And for any children that are still dependents, but they're between the ages of 19 and 24, if they are actually currently enrolled as a full-time student in college, then they will also be eligible to receive a one-time $500 payment. Now, as I mentioned, if they file as independents when they file their taxes, the same when they file for their FAFSA while they're in college, if they're doing all of that independent, that means you can't claim them because they are filing as an independent person, an independent adult. And so they would no longer be a dependent on their parents' taxes. And so basically, if you're between the age of 18 and 24, the government is basically saying you need to go and get a job. Speaking of getting more money, that takes us into number six. And so this is actually the fact that you won't receive all of the child tax credit in 2021. And so if you did the math, if you have a child that's five and under, you would receive $300 per month. That is a total of $1,800 counting from July until December. 300 times six, that's 1,800. But the actual child tax credit is 3,600. So you're only receiving half of the payment in 2021, and you'll receive the second half of that child tax credit when you file your taxes in 2022. And the same goes for children between the age of 16 and 17. That's a $250 payment. You multiply that by six and you get $1,500, which is half of the $3,000 child tax credit that you'll receive for 2021. And so you'll get the other $1,500 once you actually file taxes in 2022. But one good thing, if you happen to have a lot of children, is that the child tax credit is $3,000 or $3,600 per child. which takes us into number five, which is there is no cap. I mean, no, really, like there's no cap, like there's no maximum. So no matter how many children you have, as long as those children are eligible based on their age range, from infant up to age 17, for each of the children that you have in that age range, you will receive a monthly payment of either $300 or $250 for each of your children. So no matter if you have one child or if you have 10, you're gonna receive a payment for each of those children as long as they're 17 or under for the next 6 months. And as far as their age, the IRS is basing their age based on how old they are at the end of 2021. So if you have a 5-year-old, but they turn 6 before the end of the year, that means you will receive a $250 credit for that child instead of the $300 credit for children ages 5 and under. Speaking of new children, that takes us into number 4. And so if you had a child in 2021, or if you adopted a child in 2021, those children are also eligible for the child tax credit. And so of course, the initial payment, it will be based on how many children were actually on your taxes for 2020, whatever you filed in 2019 or 2020. That's what it's gonna base the number of payments that you receive based on those children. So if you're a person that had a child and they were born in 2021, then you will actually be able to update your information on the IRS website in order to include that child once you actually receive your child tax payment advance. And so while they don't have an exact date when you'll be able to update this information, it does say on their website that it will be available late summer. And I'll have a link to the website where you can actually make those updates. I'll leave that down below in the description as well as in the top comment below. Now, one other thing that you can update using that same link is actually the number 3 thing that you need to know, and that is that you can change the bank you use on the IRS website. And so if you either didn't use a bank account when you filed your taxes and you received a paper check, or if you just wanted to change the bank that you had the money go to, starting with the first August payment, you'll actually be able to change the bank account that those deposits go to. And so the option to update your bank account was actually made available on June 30th. Again, using the same link that I mentioned in number 4. Again, I'll make that available. You'll be able to see that in the description. Use that link to update your banking information. But this is a great time to update your bank or your savings account or anywhere you would like to transfer that money. And so if you don't need to use the money immediately, you know, to pay your rent or your mortgage, or maybe to pay for day-to-day expenses, then you can immediately put that money in a savings account that'll actually allow you to earn interest on this cash that you may not need at the moment. And so I recently did a top 5 savings video where I talked about 5 savings accounts where you can get about 3% or higher based on the checking account or the savings account or cash management account that you can use. And all of these give you the opportunity to earn 3% or higher interest on your savings or your checking account balance. And so if you changed banks recently or you would like to change your bank, make sure you use that link so you can update the bank account where these payments are received. Now, another thing that you can do on that same website is the second top thing that you need to know about these payments, and that is that you can actually opt out of the payments. And so as I mentioned, there may be some people who may not need to use it for either their rent or their mortgage or their day-to-day expenses. And if you don't want to receive that payment right now, you know, whatever your reasoning is for not receiving it, you can actually choose to opt out of receiving those payments. And so again, because this is the child tax credit, you'll still get that credit once you file your taxes in 2021. But if you don't need the money or don't want to utilize the money for whatever your reasoning is, then you actually have the choice to opt out of the payments and you'll just receive that tax credit once you file your taxes in 2022. And so some of you may be asking, why would I want to opt out of receiving free money? Like if they're going to give me money, they're going to give me hundreds of dollars per child that I have, why would I want to opt out of receiving that payment? Well, that actually takes us to the number one thing that you need to know about these child tax credit payments. And the number one thing is that it's not actually free money. So this isn't free money. This is not extra money. This is a child tax credit. This is a credit that you normally receive based on your income level every time that you file your taxes. And this is one of the reasons why that many people actually receive a refund once they file their taxes. And so instead of waiting until you file your taxes in 2022, what they did was they made this an advance payment. They split that payment in half. That's why when the child tax credit was increased to $3,600, but you're only going to receive $1,800 per child, you're actually going to receive the other $1,800 or the other $1,500 if your child is between the age of 16 and 17. You'll receive that other half once you actually file your taxes. And so if you want, if you don't want to receive the payments now, you can actually receive that full credit once you file your taxes in 2022. And one of the most important reasons why you may actually want to hold off on receiving those payments is depending on your individual tax situation. And so if you're a person that normally does not receive a refund, or maybe you don't receive a very large refund, then there's a chance that if you receive these payments, you may actually end up owing the IRS once you file your taxes in 2022. And so a simple rule of thumb that you could use is that, you know, whatever the payment that you receive in July, if that is accurate based on the children that you file on your taxes, if you multiply the amount that you received, whether it's $300 or $250, times the number of children that you have, you add those together, and then you multiply that by six based on the six payments that you would receive in 2021. If that dollar amount is more than the typical tax refund that you receive at the end of the year, then you may not want to actually take those payments. Now, I do believe that that's one of the reasons why they don't give you the full tax credit payment in advance. They're only giving you half of it. And that's because some people that are used to receiving some type of a refund, especially if it's a lower amount, if they were to give them the whole tax credit, there's a chance that many people would actually owe taxes because they don't normally receive that large of a refund at the end of the year. Now, of course, this is going to vary based on an individual basis, but you can use your tax refund history to kind of determine whether or not the amount that you're going to receive in these advance payments trumps the amount that you would normally receive when you actually file your taxes and receive your refund. And of course, if you're working less this year than you did last year, there's a chance that maybe if you normally only receive maybe a couple hundred or low thousands in a tax refund, that it may not actually affect you because you made less money this year. But if you're on the opposite end of the spectrum and you're actually making more money in 2021 than you did in 2019 and 2020, then there's a chance that you could actually end up owing money and not realize it, or may not think about it. So that could be a reason that you may not want to receive those payments in advance. And so no one wants that sticker shock of maybe having to pay the IRS back because they were, you know, received those advance payments and they're used to receiving refunds, but something changed in their tax situation and made it so that this year, because of those advance payments, you might actually have to pay some of that advance back. Now, I actually have a video, and this was mostly made for people who have a very simple tax situation. You know, maybe all you have is a W-2, you don't have your own business, and you don't have a lot of other complicated tax situations. There's a simple calculation that you can use to kind of estimate how much you should pay in taxes, and that way you can actually try to adjust your W-4 to actually lower the amount that you pay in taxes throughout the year and kind of give yourself an advanced tax credit payment throughout the year instead of waiting on this specific advance payment. And I'll actually have a link to that video. I probably have it going across the top of the screen right now. You can check that video out. Again, I am not a tax advisor. I am not an expert in tax, but this has worked for me in the past, filing my own taxes to get it to where I received the smallest amount of refund possible just by adjusting my W-4. And that way I actually make more money throughout the year instead of receiving a big refund check the next year. And trust me, you'd rather receive a smaller payment or maybe even owe a little bit of money when you file your taxes if you can get a couple hundred dollars more on your paycheck for each paycheck. And so if you don't need this money, like I mentioned, you could do your own child tax credit or any of your tax credits that you receive on your taxes. You can do that by adjusting your W-4. But specifically for this child tax credit, if you don't want to receive it, you can opt out. And you have that opportunity, and these are reasons why you might want to opt out. But if you do receive it and you don't necessarily need the cash, but you want to save it just in case you may end up owing money to the IRS, I would recommend putting it in a high yield savings account or maybe even investing the money so that it can grow from now until the point that you actually file your taxes, and then you'll have that money ready to make that payment just in case you end up owing money to the IRS. And so again, you can check out my videos. I review a lot of savings accounts, investment apps, and cashback apps. And if you want to get started with investing, also check out my Investing for Beginners playlist. It can give you some of the basics of how to get started with investing in the stock market, as well as some investing apps that you can use to not only receive free stock to get started, but also to start getting invested with a very easy to use strategy. And so whether you're going to receive the money and keep it, or if you're going to opt out of receiving it, let us know your decision down in the comments below. Also, let us know what you plan on doing with the money that you receive, whether you're going to spend it on your day-to-day expenses, or if you'll have the ability to actually save it or even invest that money because you don't necessarily need the money at this moment. All right, thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I really appreciate it. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video just like this. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.